when you think about Uganda, our backbone is agriculture, our backbone is farming, our livelihood is agriculture, and probably 90% of our population depends on agriculture. So it was a very natural project to do. Since the 1990s, we've covered farming in the New Vision newspapers and on all our other platforms. But in 2000, and I think it was 2007, when we began doing profiling the best farmers, but we were not doing it as a competition. It only became as a competition in 2014. And in 2014, it took on a new turn because then we even got in partners to support us, and it became an actual competition, a national competition. When we started in 2014, it was much smaller, but also the farmers were much smaller. You'd find that farmers were growing food for subsistence. A farmer with 10 acres of matoke was doing very well. The competition has since grown from that. This year, there was a lot of marked improvement in the type of nominations we are getting, but also in the farmers we are able to profile. The farmers are much, much, much more stronger. We've moved from subsistence farming and from small farms to larger farms. But also we've noticed that many farmers are actually investing actual money. They are doing farming as a business. You're seeing more mechanization on the farms. You're seeing people going into value addition. There are more Ugandans going into farming. When we started the competition in 2014, we had about 700 entries. 2019, we had 1,600 entries. 2020, the entries jumped up by 200. We had 1,870 entries. That is a sign that many Ugandans have actually gone into farming.
The agriculture was, you know, being looked at as completely something that somebody cannot choose for a living, for a purpose, for a livelihood. And so we thought we needed to rebrand, we needed to re-engineer this farming. And farming as a business is one of the main and key goals for the Best Farmer competition.
People had kind of lost touch with it, and they also wanted to acknowledge and appreciate the people who are doing it.
When the competition is announced, we call on all Ugandans to nominate, and anybody can nominate. Even a farmer can nominate themselves. We do not say you can't nominate yourself, because we shall go out and prove whether what you're saying is true. So the nominations come in, showing us where the farm is and what the person is doing. We then send our foot soldiers, because we've got journalists in the whole country, in every corner of the country we've got journalists. We then send them out to look out for the stories. So they will go and visit your farm and profile you. You do not need to pay any money for that to be done. There have been some con men who say, pay me some money for you to be able to win. You do not need to pay anybody money, because it's a long process, and the chances that you will win are very small by paying just one journalist. So the stories are then written, or they're recorded on TV, they're recorded on camera for TV, or even recorded on audio for radio. This year, we were able to publish 268. Out of these 268 farmers, the first internal, the judges selected 50.
For this year, unlike the previous years where we would go to the respective farms, have visits, have engagements with the competitors, this time it's been more or less virtual, in that Vision Group has been our eye on ground. They have recorded, profiled the farmers, importantly recorded the videos, we have watched them, and we have engaged and called some of the competitors. So it's been a little different from the previous year.
The judges are very distinguished Ugandans, including our former Minister of Agriculture, the Honorable Victoria Sektoleko, and they do sit and look at each of these stories. They've got category they consider, and then they do announce to us the winners. Nobody in the New Vision or among the partners knows who the winners are going to be until the judges have sat separately to announce who the winners are. So if anybody has won today, it's not because you know anybody in New Vision. It's because you actually deserve the win.
I would like to thank the agribusiness sector, all those people who are growing trees, growing fish. I want to thank you for sticking with your business. And along those lines, I would like to request that for anybody who is thinking of going into farming, first find out exactly what do you want to grow. Who else is doing it? Who is part of your value chain? Be part of a value chain so that whatever you are growing, you know who is working with you. If let's say you are going to plant avocado, you should know who gives the right seeds, who has got the agronomic information, extension workers, and who will buy when you are ready to sell. Don't go it alone and one day wake up and say, I have got 800 kilograms of ginger, who wants to buy?
The competition has continued to become popular among the farmers. When these farmers who win go to the Netherlands and then come back and tell their stories, many farmers have tended to come up and also try their luck so that when they win, or if they win, they can also get that opportunity.
Once these people travel and see what has been done in that country, their level of ambitions really grow. You are only comparing yourself with your neighbor and you think you are the best. But the moment you cross the other region and you see what it means to engage in farming as a business, your level of ambition, your level of inspiration becomes even much bigger. And that comes together with the knowledge that these people get when they interact with the Dutch farmers. That comes together with the business opportunities that they also explore when they interact with these Dutch people. It comes with the seeing of new technologies. When we are there, we always do what we call matchmaking. And the matchmaking is where this individual Ugandan farmer sits with another Dutch farmer out there or another Dutch company, and then they sit together and see what businesses can we do together. Where can we, you know, connect so that we together improve our businesses. Maybe I can be a market for your product. We also have what we call the retired experts from the Netherlands. We usually call them PUM experts. They meet these guys and advise them on how to improve on their businesses.
COVID-19, of course, it was a bad thing that it happened. All organizations closed, but the farming organization didn't close. I said, yes, we've been made the essential people, because each time we keep telling people that we are essential, maybe sometimes don't know. Like, and there's this saying that if you've eaten lunch, if you've eaten breakfast, if you've taken something, then you have to appreciate a farmer. And at that particular time in COVID-19, when the lockdown was real serious, the farmers stayed in their fields producing food for everyone, because we were asked to eat very well. We were asked to eat fruits, we were asked to take fruits, vegetables, all these things were to boost our immunity. So, and the farmer was at the core front of this. Many people started actually selling or started doing value addition, even if they were cottage, but they were learning a few things and they were trying to preserve.
Most of the people out there who lost jobs, they were border riders and they couldn't continue. They were teachers and the schools were closed. I think the fallback position has been farming. And don't get surprised when some of those guys actually don't go back to those border riding or teaching or whatever, and they still get stuck within agriculture, within farming, because they have seen the profitability of this sector.
The competition is still on, and over the 7 years I've been judging, at least most of the locations have had winners. So the best they can do is to look for those colleagues of theirs in their respective villages who have ever won in the competitions. They go and actually talk to them and they see how those people manage to win. Because normally there are a number of criteria which we consider before a farmer can win. So if a winning farmer finds out one of his or her colleagues who has ever won the competitions, go there and understand him or her, they will stand a chance of also winning.
The extension workers, especially when we go out of Wakiso, Kampala, and maybe Mukono, the far ends, like in the east, in the north, deep there, people don't have extension workers. Sometimes even I wonder what the districts the production officers are doing in the district or the district veterinary officers. So the extension services are very poor. Farmers out there really have the passion to farm. They want to farm, they want to produce. But then there's a gap. No one is to tell them what to do.
I want to thank all those who have participated in the competition, especially those who didn't win. I'm definitely sure you learned something, even if you didn't win. My suggestion to the government of Uganda is let the executive work with parliament and pass the privatization act of a crutch extension so that the private organizations can join extension working. That way, nearly everybody will be taken care of. As we talk now, there are many people who are trying, but unfortunately failing because of lack of extension services. I would like to thank the supporters for, one, first of all, agreeing to sponsor this program, but most importantly, staying with it for the last 7 years. Now we are in the 8th year and they are still there. Most importantly, in spite of COVID, none of our sponsors has said, oh no, this thing is not going anywhere, so I'm out. Thank you for sticking with us.
We'd like to thank our sponsors, the Embassy of the Kingdom of Netherlands in Uganda, DFCU Bank, Cowardice Uganda, and KLM for sponsoring this competition. For all these years, they've stood with us, and even in the difficult COVID time, they stood with us. We are aware that the best farmers for 2019 have not yet traveled, but they'll still travel, and the ones for 2020, they've assured us that the ones for 2020 will also travel. It's just because of the lockdown, but when all this is done, they'll be able to go. And there are also plans to do a scientific expo in April, but after that, the travel will still happen. So we really appreciate them for putting in the time and for putting in the money. But we also thank Vision Group Management and Board for making this possible, because without the huge sponsorship, it wouldn't be possible. This competition costs us a lot of money, probably over 3 billion shillings every time we do it. And this is contributed by the partners, and we're really grateful for them. Yes, 3 billion, because it also includes the space we spend in on TV and radio and in the newspapers.